They asked, why do I upload my videos around 3 to 3:15 in the morning? To answer that question, it's very complex. Number one is I have these free trials right here, these AOL free trials. So I use these to get access to the internet, and I can only gain access late at night. I also have another one right here, and you can find these, you know, they're on AOL.com. I think they still have these. If not, then I mean, where have you been? All jokes aside, no, I typically have my videos scheduled to go live at around 3 in the morning. I think somebody out there is awake and they are bored and they want to see what I have to share. But with that being said, let me go ahead and get started. This is where we left off last time. We were able to install the windows, the door. We also put in the garage door, and we added a little vent right here at the top. And we did the same on the opposite side as well. What you're seeing right now, it's literally it. Like, this is the final stage. Now, if you don't know how I got to this part, be sure to check out my part 1, part 2, and part 3 of the 3D Builder series. I'm going to start using another software that I love using. 3D Builder is okay because it's good, but it's very limited because you can't do a lot of the extra things. You can't get down to the vertex and the edges level of 3D modeling, and that's what I typically do all the time. So how do we get this into a physical format? You know, one that we can actually hold in our hand. How do we do that? Where do we go? If you haven't already done this, you should be saving your files. Not only that, you should be saving multiple versions of your files, because in a situation where you slip up, you make a big oopsie or a big mistake, you're gonna want to go back to where you started or that previous stage you were at. How do we save this? Well, you see this little 3-line thing here? You just click on that and then you click on save as. Very simple, straightforward. All right, so now that we have the save as dialog box open, you're gonna notice, this should look familiar to you guys. I mean, okay, anyway, there's a drop down menu right here that says save as type. You click on that and you'll be greeted by, I think, what is this, six different options, six different file formats that you could save your 3D model in. OBJ, sometimes you'll see this being referred to as a wavefront file. They're both, I mean, all of these options, they should be compatible with the slicing software that we're about to use. I typically stick with OBJ because I think I have a little bit more luck with that. Go ahead and select OBJ format. You see where it says 3D building house. I don't know why I called it that. Let me just call it house. Like, it's a house, right? Once you click that, you could save it. You'll notice another dialog box comes up. This is the texture file. It's an MTL file. It saves the data for the textures. Save it, but you're not gonna need it because the slicing software that we're gonna be using, it's not gonna put a material or a texture on your 3D model once it's printed. Like, it doesn't happen. I'm gonna go ahead and start shifting gears and start talking about slicing software. So you might be wondering, what is slicing software? Why do you keep saying slicing software? What is that? Slicing software, it's basically the middleman. It's the gateway from getting your 3D model into the 3D printer. It's the thing in the middle. In order for us to print this house, we're gonna have to convert this 3D model into a series of layers. And it's going to be saved as a G-code file. So you've been hearing me talk about OBJ and 3MFs. Well, yeah, we're going to have to save this again, but we're not going to have to worry too much about it. What I want you guys to do, if you've made it this far in, go online and download Cura. It's a free slicing software. It has a lot of powerful tools that you can use. It's great. I'm not going to show you how to do that. You guys are smart enough to figure that out yourself. Okay, so once you have this program downloaded, you're gonna be greeted by a screen like this. Now, like I said in the beginning, I am on a dark mode version of Windows. So your Cura thing might not look like this. This is a lot easier on my eyes. That's why I like the dark mode of everything. So what we're gonna do is import our OBJ file. All you need to do is just click on File, Open File. All right, so here it is right here. It's house, that's the file. We're gonna go ahead and open it. It's an OBJ. And there it is in all of its glory. Yeah, that's That's not where we want it though. What you'll notice is this cube right here represents our build plate. Click on the model. You'll be greeted by a screen like this. You'll have the X, the Y, and the Z axis. I'm gonna go ahead and set everything to zero. So all you have to do is just highlight the numbers, click zero, zero. There you go. Man, my nose, oh boy. It's still too big. So how do we adjust this? How do we make this smaller? Well, click on it again. You see this button right here? It looks like two chess pieces. Well, and it says scale, obviously. We're gonna scale it down. So click on that button. And right now, we have everything set to 100%. We can, you know, go with 20%, why not? 20% is probably way too small. So I'm gonna just scale it up to 40. There we go, that works. 40%. And I'm gonna zoom in a little closer. And notice how the whole model just changed from like a weird zebra striped color to this yellow. Now it's telling us that the model is indeed located inside of the build volume. That's a good thing. What we're gonna do now is click the slice button. Again, so easy. It's slicing it right now. And right now it gives us some information here. It says it's gonna take us 4 hours and 34 minutes to print this out. It's gonna take 29 grams of filament. All right. And it's gonna cost us 57 cents. That might be a little off. This actually might cost a little bit more to print because of how high the prices are right now with the filament, but it's great. Great feature. I love that Cura does that. All right, and we're gonna click on preview. All right, let's see what that looks like. All right, yeah, that's about it. So when I zoom in, you'll notice all these little lines here. That is supposed to represent each layer. And if you wanted to go in, you know, in a specific spot right there, and just inspect it while, you know, you don't have it sent to the printer just yet, you can do that. And that's what makes Cura so user-friendly. Okay, so you have your model in the slicing software. What next? What do I do? How do I get this to the 3D printer? Well, you, my friend, will need, number one, a 3D printer, but also you're gonna need something like this. You're gonna need a micro SD card. Now this is a SD card adapter, but you're gonna stick the micro SD card on the bottom of this. You just plug it into your computer, like so, and you'll be greeted with a screen that says save to SD card or save to removable drive. Once you see that, you can select that and it'll save it to your thing. So the next step is to go to the printer. Take your SD card with you. Go to the printer. Let's go ahead and get the printer set up. Okay, so I'm not sure what kind of printer you have, but this is the Ender 3. I'm just gonna cycle through the menu here. TF card refers to the SD card. So just click on that and you'll notice, there it is right there, 3D building house. Okay, so after a week of printing, we've ended up with this. Okay, it didn't take a week. It took, I think, 4 hours, 5 hours. Yeah, the time's a little off on that, but it didn't take that long. This is what it looks like in real life. I told you I wanted to make it the size of my hand or the palm of my hand. So what do we do with this? Well, you can do a lot of things with it. You could paint it, give it to a friend, eat it. No, don't eat it. Yeah, it's pretty hard. It's pretty tough plastic. It'll take a while to break this apart, but you can see how it's hollow on the inside. I think there was a little bit of a problem right there in the corner. Very simple stuff. So if you're interested in this, definitely stay tuned. I'll have more videos coming out in the future. Just want to say thank you all so much for supporting the channel. This is very cool technology, and I want a lot of you to explore it, because you can make stuff like this. You can make actually useful things. This, I don't think this is very useful, but this is you know, something that you can make. With that being said, thank you all so much for watching. Hope you have a good one, and I'll see you in the next video.